Welcome, aviation enthusiasts, to this production on the Perth Aviation Heritage Museum. You're welcomed by a spitfire at the entrance. It's well worthwhile paying your admission fee to get in. It's a great museum. The beginnings of flight, dreaming of flying. At the entrance is the Scorpion do-it-yourself helicopter. A bit frightening. The museum's only recently got a Catalina, and back in the early 1970s I had the good fortune to do a flight on a Canadian Cancel from Moosonee to Fort Albany up on James Bay in the Arctic of Northern Ontario. Signs, 1945, on the Catalina crew headquarters. Catalina played a very important role during the Second World War, search and rescue. These cover paintings are featured in the Australian War Museum. An operational Catalina. Instruments of the Catalina. Pictured here in the museum. Cooking up a meal on a Catalina on a routine patrol, World War II. There were over 3,280 of these boats constructed during the Second World War. That's it for the Catalina, a hot air balloon. There's a huge collection of engines from the First World War right up to almost the present. Too many to go over, but I'll look at one or two. This engine is one of the ones on the B-29 Super Fortress used to drop the atomic bomb on Hiroshima. An engine from the First World War, made by Renault. The aircraft that first started running a passenger service between Perth and Rottnest Island. One of Horry Miller's Wackets, he was the founder of the McRobertson Miller Airlines, or MMA, and his daughter Robin became famous as the Sugarbird Lady, flying as a nurse up to the Northwest to service sick Aboriginal patients. The big section on communications. Including radar control. There's a historical section on the battle for air supremacy in the First World War. The Walrus, an amphibious aircraft, was used for marine exploration from on board ships. Previous plane was used for Australia's first regular airmail contract in the northern part of Western Australia. Service began in 1921 using a Bristol Tourer Type 28 aircraft from Geraldton. Six aircraft were purchased by the West Australian Airways and during 5 years of operation covered 1.2 million kilometers. A DC-3, I think, had the good fortune to fly in one, also up in the James Bay area in the 1970s. An Abro Anson. Let's look at some historical photographs from the Australian War Museum of the Anson. Used as a World War II bomber aircraft. Tiger Moth. Still lots of these flying around. They were manufactured in Sydney during the Second World War. The Hawker Hurricane. This one was constructed over a 10-year period as a 5/8 replica. They were used by the British to fight the Germans in 1940, the Battle of Britain. The Mackie Jet, these were used during the 1960s in Vietnam, I think. World War II Spitfire, like the one outside. These planes came to play a crucial role in defending the Northern Territory against Japanese fighters and bombers. The Canberra Bomber. the Vampire jet, developed to teach pilots to fly new jet aircraft. About 200 were made in Australia. Thanks for joining me, aircraft enthusiast, on this visit to the Perth Heritage Aviation Museum, located in Bulls Creek, open 7 days a week. Have a great day.